high expectations in the beginning of the blessed month of Ramadan. Alhamdulillah, once again, is a reminder for us in the last days, and we can still make up for our weaknesses. So just to go over what we discussed, the first point that we discussed on the first night of Ramadan was three reasons of sin. And the first is Satan, the second is nafs, and the third is bad company. And we said Satan is not put in the blessed month of Ramadan. Nafs is controlled by hunger and thirst, provided that we don't overeat at suhoor time and iftar time. If we eat less, then nafs will be in control. And the only third enemy that we have, the third reason for sinning, is bad company. And I said, if you can refrain from bad company, you'll be purified in the blessed month of Ramadan. That's all that we have to work on. I'm really happy, alhamdulillah. I have a very high percentage of people in the reports that were sent to me, people who didn't watch any movies in the month of Ramadan, people who completely disconnected the internet, some people stopped using the games and their phones and things like that. That's a big achievement, because I said that's the third cause of sinning. Sinning, bad company is not only people, it's also these apps on your phones and internet and watching movies. That's the bad company that we need to refrain from, we really need to work hard on. And alhamdulillah, a lot of people have been working on that. And if you people are still guilty of this sin of watching that which is haram or something which is unnecessary, because it's not a month of entertainment, it is to attain the nearness of Allah Jalla wa'ala, to enjoy the hunger and thirst and gain the nearness of Allah Jalla wa'ala. Then here is another opportunity, another reminder for all of us, for the coming 10 days, we work hard on that inshallah and act upon the ahkam of deen. The second talk was about to be blessed with life in Ramadan is a great honor, and I gave the example of Sayyidina Al-Habib Abdullah of Allah Ta'ala. And to keep thanking Allah Ta'ala, we thank you that you blessed us with life in this blessed month of Ramadan. Point number three, the third talk was how angels pray for those people who are fasting and there's someone else eating next to that person. And until the other person finishes, Allah Ta'ala appoints his angels and they keep doing dua for the fasting person until the other person finishes eating. So that's a great blessing. If you're at work and someone else is eating next to you, then thank Allah that Allah has blessed you with this opportunity, with this great blessing that the angels are descending from the heavens and they're especially making du'as for you until the other person finishes eating. The fourth talk was about picking up food, pieces of bread or other food from the dining mat, and how the person is forgiven if he picks up food and he eats it. And that forgiveness is guaranteed by Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and how the people who pick up food from the floor and eat it, how their children will be intelligent, and how Allah Jalla wa'ala will bless them with barakah, with blessings in the sustenance, and the children will be saved from insanity. They will have beautiful children. Point number five was, the fifth talk was about Quran and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam increasing in charity the day after Rasulullah would meet Jibreel. So Jibreel at night would come and recite the Quran to the Prophet and the Prophet would recite back to Jibreel, and then the Prophet would increase in charity on the following day in giving charity, and then we discussed the reasons behind that. And Rasulullah would receive the love letter from Allah Jalla wa'ala. That is the Quran, that's the Kalam of Allah Jalla wa'ala. The scholars of Quranic thesis is that you thank Allah. So if you meet someone pious, one way of thanking Allah for that is to give in charity. So the Prophet ﷺ, as if the Prophet ﷺ was meeting Allah, because the Quran was given to the Prophet ﷺ. And the next day, the Prophet's charity would be like blowing wind, like a tornado, to reach everyone. When you meet someone pious, based on this hadith, someone who's greater than you, then you should increase your charity. You should give more sadaqah if you meet someone who's greater than you, someone more pious. And who's greater than the Prophet ﷺ? Allah. So this was a meeting between Allah and the Prophet ﷺ. The kalam of Allah was given to the Prophet ﷺ. And Rasulullah ﷺ would thank Allah for receiving the mercy from Allah. So why shouldn't we thank Allah for the mawlid of the Prophet ﷺ? So this is the point for mawlid also. Because when we receive the blessing of Allah in the form of the Prophet ﷺ, we should increase the salah. Then we talked about, the sixth talk was delay in tawbah, and the two types of people who make tawbah. The tawbah which is accepted and the tawbah which is rejected. A detailed lecture was delivered on that. And the practical methods of tawbah and how a person, if he sins, then he is given 6 hours to repent. If he repents within the 6 hours, then that sin is not written. That person's sin is not written. So other points of tawbah were mentioned in that. The seventh talk was man sama Ramadan and man qama. Whoever fasting the blessed month of Ramadan is forgiven. And I said Ramadan is not limited to fasting only. Ramadan is not only about not eating, it's also about not sleeping. Sleeping less, that when we eat less in the same way, we sleep less. And then we talked about the how those people who sleep during the day, how they are deprived from the blessings of the blessed month of Ramadan. So sleep less in the month of Ramadan. The same talk we talked about the example that we are constantly thinking about in Taraweeh, that for Taraweeh, for every sajda, 1,500 good deeds are written in our account. For every sajda, every Taraweeh, we should be thinking about that. If someone makes a poster that in this masjid, you will get £1,500 for every sajda in Taraweeh, everyone would be here. You wouldn't have to make any phone calls to remind people, but here it is hasanat. Imagine that if someone says £1,500 for every sajda that you perform, you will get us guaranteed. Imagine this place would be packed out. It's still a blessing, alhamdulillah. So many people come, alhamdulillah. So just remember this in your sajda. 1,500 good deeds are written in every sajda, alhamdulillah. Then the eighth lecture was the shukr of Allah, and I talked about it's like 1 + 1 = 2. That's how the law is. This is the Islamic law. Gratitude increases Allah's blessings. Ingratitude decreases Allah's blessings. So rather than complaining about what we don't have, let us make a habit. And in our control, our manhaj, every night muhasabah that we do in those who are bare in this tariqah, every night muhasabah, 1 point in muhasabah is we count the blessings of Allah and we thank Allah Jalla wa Ala. So don't talk about what you don't have. Talk about what you have and thank Allah, because this is a promise from Allah. لَا إِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. Make a habit every night before going to sleep. Thank Allah for your eyes. Thank Allah for your hands, for your feet, your tongue, your ears, your house, your children, your family. Count the blessings of Allah and say, Allah, I thank you for what you blessed me with. Stop mourning and complaining about what you don't have. And this is a guarantee. Gratitude increases Allah's blessings. Allah will give you everything if we change our approach and give thanks to Allah. Then we talked about the beautiful hadith, and the Prophet stood up and he said, look who's coming, O people. And then the Sahaba was surprised, and the Prophet said, look, Ramadan is coming. It's Ramadan. Rasulullah was happiness and excitement. And then we talked about how the fish in the sea, they pray for the fasting person, and how the birds pray for the person who's fasting, and how 1 million people are freed from the fire of hell, but 4 people. And then how for every day, if you recite Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, Wa la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, 70,000 angels are appointed. They keep making dua for forgiveness until iftar time. So make a habit of doing this. Let us recite this once again. Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, Wa la ilaha illallah, Wallahu Akbar. Subhanallah. Then the 10th lecture was a summary of all the previous talks. The 11th talk was the importance of dua and how we are connected. How there is a strong and deep relationship between the blessed month of Ramadan and dua, and why Allah Jalla wa Ala in verse 183, 184, 185, and 186. In between these verses, Allah mentions the importance and ahkam of fasting, and then Allah emphasizes the importance of dua and how we can connect and establish our link with Allah with individual duas. Ibn Atayillah Sikandri Rahimahullah's teachings, we mentioned that he said, you have to believe and persuade yourself that you are helpless. You are not in command of your life, you are not in control of your life. If we persuade ourselves, then we will shed tears in our duas and we will have a connection in our duas. Then point number 12 was the dua at the time of iftar, constantly reminding ourselves. This is the dua that is accepted. At the time of iftar, when we worry about the food, think about your relationship with Allah. Before we eat, we should make a dua, and also the importance of dua at the time of sahur. So, lecture number 13 was about the importance of silatul rahim, importance of joining ties of relationship. How many of us have actually gone to our relatives and people who have distanced themselves from us to solve and resolve all our grievances and ikhtilafat and ask for forgiveness, even if they are wrong, even if they have oppressed you, but to seek their forgiveness, to be blessed from the barakahs of the blessed month of Ramadan. And how those people who are guilty of breaking ties of relationship, how they do not benefit from the blessings of Ramadan. And lecture number 14 was the azab of not fasting, as I talked about yesterday as well. There are many people in our community that they do not fast. So we talked about the punishments of those who do not fast, and those who fast and then they break their fast. And number 15 was the importance of respecting the house of Allah. Some very important lessons were taught about, and especially those people who are in itikaf. And I told them, mentioned that you can't do good in the house of Allah. You cannot eat in the house of Allah. It's haram to sleep in the house of Allah unless you make the intention of itikaf. So whenever you enter in the masjid, make an intention of itikaf. Even if you've got water for dhamm, do not drink that water. Drinking, eating and sleeping in the house of Allah, it is haram unless you make the intention of itikaf. So how do you make the intention of itikaf? You can say it in English, Allah, I make the intention of itikaf. The lecture after that was about the link between Quran and why Allah mentions, gives the example of rain in the Quran and how dead plant is revived, given life by rain, and how Quran gives life to dead hearts. So we need to ask ourselves, what have we thanked Allah for blessing us with Quran? And then we talked about Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, Injil, after the revelation of Injil for 600 years there was no wahi, and then there was a great ni'mah which Allah mentions as a great blessing that was sent after darkness, and Allah says this darkness kept increasing and people were waiting for light, and then the light came in the form of the Quran, and we have that light, and the month of the light, the nur that came from Allah, is the blessed month of Ramadan. How many of you have actually read the Quran? How many of, what is your favorite surah in the Quran? If I ask you this question, you know, I've come across Christians, I've come across atheists who come to debate me about the existence of Allah Jalla wa Ala. When they ask them, they say that Muslims, they do not have a favorite surah of the Quran. They do not know which surah is the best surah. They study the Quran to refute the Muslims. They know the Shan and Nuzul and the reasons why the rest of the Quran were revealed. But unfortunately, it is the blessed month of Ramadan, but we are still not connected with the Quran. That letter is written for us, but we haven't even read that letter yet. Let us make this niyyah, inshallah, in the coming last 10 days of Ramadan. We will recite the Quran, those of you who are deprived of this name. And then we talked about Imam Ahmad Rizal Rahimahullah's dream, how Allah Rahimahullah was cured in the blessed month of Ramadan. His father has told him in his dream. His father came in his dream and told him that you will fall ill, but make sure you do not miss the Zom of Ramadan. So he kept fasting, and then he was cured because of the benefits of, the, of fasting. And then yesterday's talk was about backbiting. That how to control your tongue, and how some people, they do not benefit from the blessed month of Ramadan. It is nothing more than the hunger, thirst, and remain awake. So if you want to benefit, then we have to control our tongues, we have to control our eyes, we have to control our hands, and we mentioned many hadiths regarding that. So make niyyah, inshallah, coming 10 days, we'll act upon this, inshallah. Each day, just a reminder for everyone, invite all your friends, all your relatives, they are brothers, mashallah, will be coming from other cities as well, and we're thinking of the Eid prayer, there will be refreshments, and also Nasheed artists will be coming, and we'll have an atmosphere, a spiritual atmosphere, inshallah. So, what time do you think? We were thinking between 9 and 9:30. We couldn't really decide. Some people are coming from other cities as well. So, what time do you guys want to come? What do you suggest?